Okay, this is again a jumbled sentence. So let's quickly look at it. So let's identify a topic sentence. That's the first thing that we do, right? All it has to do. It refers to what? It is easy, the record shows, for a garment to do harm to its... So here, it has to do as in, it's talking about something that has to take some action. And then B starts off saying, it is easy, the record shows. So here, in B sentence, the record shows for a garment to do harm to its domestic economy. So basically, let's go to C. C says, contrary to what economists confidently promised, okay, I'm just highlighting some keywords. They still operate pretty much the way they have been. So they're talking about business cycles. Who's they referring to? We have to figure it out. E, but there is not the slightest evidence that any government policy... So let's look at links quickly before we decide on the topic sentence, right? Okay, so if you ask me, I'm looking at sentence A is talking about some damage that is done, right? Look at the repeat words here, damage, damage. And then B also talks about government doing harm to its domestic economy. So how can this happen? I'm just asking a question. How can this happen? What? The government harming its domestic economy. All it has to do is drive up the inflation rate. And then there are, pay attention to this hyphen, okay? Examples are the damage Lyndon Johnson's inflationary policies did to the US economy and the damage which consistently pro-inflationary policies have done to the economy of Italy. So it's giving you two examples of the local damages done in different cities, which is in London, countries in London and Italy. Okay, so BA seems to be a link. They still operate pretty much the way they have been operating. So CD also seems to be a link. Why? Because the they is referring to the economists. Contrary to what economists confidently promised 40 years ago, business cycles have not been abolished. How is that? They still operate pretty much the way they have been operating for the past 150 years. So it started 150 years back. It's still not, it's not abolished. It's still operating the same way. So CD is a definite link. BA is a definite link. So what about this E? But there is not the slightest evidence that any government policy to stimulate the economy has impact, whether that policy be Keynesian, monetarist, supply side or neoclassical. I would fit E after A. So I think most of you are coming back, you've given me a thing, sequence, because I think A is directly answering B. How can the government do harm to its domestic economy? All it has to do is drive up the inflation rate. That's the answer. The answer to the question, how can the government do harm to its domestic economy? Because it's still making, you know, connect to the government and the economy. So I would say B, I would fit E here. B, E, A, C, D. But why should C come after E is something that we can look at. So it starts off saying, hey, it is easy for a government to do harm to its domestic economy. What it has to do, all it has to do is drive up the inflation rate. There are examples given, but there is not the slightest evidence that any government policy to stimulate the economy has impact. Whether the policies, and they've given examples of various policies. Now, contrary to what economists confidently promised 40 years ago, business cycles have not been abolished. They still operate pretty much the way they have been operating for the past 150 years. So I would go with B, E, A, C, D as a sequence rather than what most of you have come back and said. Because I think E, A has established the fact that though this is the reason why harm can happen to the domestic policies, given the examples, but there is no evidence. And to prove that, C and D are saying, hey, we've been running business over the last 150 years and nothing pretty much has impacted the economy as such. So contrary to what economists confidently promised 40 years ago, business cycles have not been abolished. They still operate pretty much the way they have been operating for the past 150 years. So most of you are coming back and saying CDBAE, but I'm going with BAE, CD as a sequence. CD is complementing the previous three sentences and not the other way around. Take a look at the passage again. If you look at the overall context, if you look at CD, CD is giving me nothing negative, right? CD is saying, hey, economists said something, But business cycles have not been abolished. They are still operating pretty much the same way. And that is in line with E rather than other any other sequence. Because all B, A, E is talking about is negative. In fact, B and A is talking about something negative. E is contradicting that. Okay, E is contradicting that. And that's why B, A, E, C, D. So B and A are negative meanings, right? Do you all agree with that? Let's break it down. B saying government can do harm to its domestic economy. A is answering that question. All it has to do is to drive up the inflation. Examples are given. And then E is coming and saying, contradicting, hey, but you know what? There is not much evidence. And then C and D only expands on that saying, nothing much has happened. Nothing has been affected in the economy. Business is still going smooth for the last 150 years and there's no problem. So in terms of expressing meaning, positive, negative, we start off with B, A, and then E, and then C, D substantiates on that. If most of you are still not convinced, we can take this up in the forum again. Again, I don't want to spend too much time on this. So most of you have come back and said it's C, D, B, A, E, and some of you are saying C, D, E, B, A. Right? This is the contention which we can probably take up.